Now we want to know about the short-run profits in perfect competition. And we know that the firm is operating at its maximum output, profit maximization output level, when the MR is equal to MC, right? So as we know, this is firm's average revenue curve, which is equal to marginal revenue in case of perfect competition, and this is marginal cost curve. And since it is intersecting the marginal revenue over here, where marginal revenue is equal to marginal cost, let's call this point A. So this is the point where the firm will be efficiently producing the profit maximization output. And this would be the firm's efficient level of output. Let's denote it by Q. You very well know that the x-axis denotes the quantity and the y-axis denotes the price, revenue and costs, right? So this is the efficient level of output. Now we have to find out in what situations a firm is earning profits in the short run. So firm will earn profits if the average total cost is less than the prices, or which is average revenue as well. So I can say average total cost is less than the average revenue. So you remember average total cost curve, which was U-shaped? So this is average total cost curve, which is U-shaped, and marginal cost is passing through the minimum point of this average total cost curve. Now, how would I show that average total cost is less than the price? So you can observe that this average total cost curve is below this red price line. So let us now find out the total revenue of the firm. Okay, so if the firm is producing the OQ level of output, the total revenue is given by price times the quantity. Okay, so it will be represented by the rectangle PAQO. Now, since I know that profit is equal to total revenue minus total cost, so I would be willing to find out the total cost as well, for which I'll have to find out the cost first. So you guys observe that at least at this output level, this is touching the cost curve at this particular point. Let us call this point S. Let's call this point R and this point as S. So basically OS represents the average total cost, right? If I want to find out the total cost, then total cost is equal to average total cost times the quantity. So average total cost is OS times the quantity OQ. So our total cost would be equal to the rectangle OSRQ. So if I want to find out the profit, total revenue minus total cost, you can see from the shaded portion. So this is given by SPAR. This is the shaded portion. So this shaded portion is actually the amount of profit that the firm will be getting in the short run.